Recognizing our constitutional right that we are citizens of one Malaysia, there are no two Malaysias in this country, therefore we can use the word that has been in our vocabulary for centuries as a word that is applicable, a word that we treasure, a word that has become part of our culture. So, and therefore we are pleased that the court has recognized us from a constitutional point of view.
Backlash from Muslim majority.
We have not had this for 400 years, and we have been using it, and we are using it every day in our churches. We are using it every day. There has never been so, and I don't think it will be so. Even the political party PAS said that it is possible for us to use the word, and we can use the word Allah. So it is not an exclusive copyrighted word for anybody. It is a generic term that is used when before Islam, also used by other in other countries. But I have before here a Bible in Arabic, and the word Allah is used. You know, and it's used in Cairo, and in Egypt, and in all other parts of the Muslim world as well. So there's no problem.
You know?
I don't want to say this. You don't want to be euphoric about this and say this is a victorious thing. No, it's a day. It's a justice day. You know, that is what we ask for, justice, and we gain this justice. Or as I said it before to some of my friends, it's a proverbial day for hell, because for the last 3 years, it is on the 31st of December that we have been getting permit, and now on this day we have got this wonderful gift. And we thank the Lord, we thank everyone for this beautiful day.
Over here.
I'm all over the place.
Ini melibatkan hak-hak yang dibangkitkan dalam perlembagaan usuhan. Contohnya artikel 10, artikel 11, artikel 12 menyentuh soal kebebasan agama, kebebasan bersuara dan dari hal pendidikan. So, saya kena kaji dululah dari aspek perundangan itu dan cuba dapatkan input daripada kementerian. Sebab saya dipahamkan bahawa kementerian telah pun isu permit barulah untuk tahun 2010. Jadi saya nak lihat sama ada syarat-syarat yang dikenakan dalam permit baru itu sama dengan syarat di dalam 209. Sebab saya percaya bahawa, dan saya juga telah bangkitkan dalam mahkamah tadi, sama ada perintah mahkamah ini cuma confine ataupun cuma bagus untuk permit 2009. Ataupun permohonan yang dibuat di mahkamah untuk mengenepikan keputusan menteri di dalam permit, di bawah permit pada tahun 2009. Dan sama ada keputusan menteri pada dalam permit 2010 ini juga tertakluk kepada perintah mahkamah itu. Okay? Jadi saya nak lihat dululah apa permit baru yang dikeluarkan menteri, dan saya telah minta wakil kementerian tadi untuk rujuk perkara ini kepada kementerian dan maklumkan kepada saya kemudian. Okey, dan ada kemungkinan lah kalau ianya melibatkan peruntukan undang yang kita rasa kita perlu rayu, kita akan buat rayuan lah. Okey, itu saja. Terima kasih. Ya, ya, ya.